Hi everyone, I'm Jamie Vaughn with Singing Muse Magazine, and I'm here today with Mark Bishop to talk about his Grammy nomination for his latest album, Beautiful Day. Hey Mark, how are you?
Good, Jamie, how you doing?
I'm doing great. I am doing great. Finally, the snow has melted in Nashville. How about where you are?
You know, that same band that came up diagonally across you guys came straight up to where we were at. I'm just below Lexington, Kentucky. Mm-hmm. So you guys got a bunch of ice and then some snow on top of it. Is that right? Right. That's what we got.
Yeah.
We went without electricity from Sunday night to Wednesday night. But we're so used to it. Where we're at here in the mountains, we anticipate that's going to happen a couple of times a winter.
Okay.
So I've got a generator and kerosene heaters, and we just kind of camp out for a few days every winter.
Oh, goodness. Well, thankfully, my neighborhood did not lose power, because I don't know what I would have done.
You're not a hillbilly like I am.
I'm a Floridian who, you know, I have a fireplace in my new house and I don't know how to use it.
Oh, so. Jamie, that white stuff is called snow.
Thanks. Where I grew up, that white stuff was called sand. So,
yeah.
But we are really excited to talk to you today about your Grammy nomination, which is phenomenal. It's for the category called the Best Roots Gospel Album. And you are nominated with some pretty stellar people. You know, you've got the Crab Family and the Irwins and Ernie Haas in Signature Sound, and then the Fisk Jubilee Singers for their 150th anniversary album. But we want to talk to you today about your album, Beautiful Day. What was it like recording that?
Well, for one thing, just hearing you list my name with all of those other folks there, that's a triumph right there. You know, that's an achievement. And everybody, I've been doing this for about 30 some odd years now. So, you know, every now and then you get, you get your nominations and your awards, and you've got plaques and little statues that you sit on the shelf in the office. And that's great stuff. But, the prize is to get to share the gospel with folks. So I'm just glad to be listed with all those other folks that love the Lord and love sharing the gospel. So, as far as recording this Beautiful Day album, you know, the times that we've been living in for the last year or two, I believe that God foresaw what we needed to do on that album. And it's such an optimistic, happy album. I mean, the name of the album is It's a Beautiful Day. And the rest of the songs on the album kind of reinforce that. So I think it's just a good album for the time that we're in. If you're looking for a message of hope and encouragement, which that's what the gospel is. That's what the gospel of Christ is a message of hope and comfort and encouragement for our hearts. And that's what we wanted to make this album. So I think that's why it resonates.
Good. What was it like to hear that you had won a nomination for the Grammys?
I think it was Greg Bentley from Crossroads called me up, said congratulations, and I said, for what? And he said, man, you got Beautiful Days, a Grammy nominated album now. So I'm mostly excited for all of the people that work with me to help put that together, because even though it's a CD in it and it's got Mark Bishop across the front, of course, all you have to do is open it up and look at the credits and you see, wow, what a team it took to get all of this together. So I just kind of get to be the face on the front of it. But once you listen to it, you hear the craftsmanship and the work and the talent of a lot of people.
Yeah.
From the arrangements to the musical performances and the other vocal performances that are on the album. And then there's the talent of the art department that gets it all together and makes it look good. And there's the promotion department. Yeah. And they've got departments. I don't even know what we do in Crossroads, but everybody has a hand in the success of that. So I'm just happy for them. And so whenever we get together, we're working on a new album now. So when we get together, we talk about, man, congratulations. I get to congratulate them. Congratulations, Jeff, man, we've got a Grammy nominated album. And that's cool. Of course, that's never been our main focus, especially in gospel music and Christian music. You know, we want to encourage and share the love of Christ with folks, and that's the main purpose. And you record many albums that may not be recognized in the way of an award or a spot on a chart, but God's keeping tabs, and I think He keeps a different success ratio chart somewhere. He's looking at, okay, wow, I can use this song to minister to this person over here.
Yeah, I don't think people realize how many people behind the scenes at the label actually do have some part and have their fingerprints on them.
Oh, yes, yes. And each one is very vital.
Very much so.
You know, you open up a watch and you look at all of those little gears and spindles and things that are turning, and you take one little one out and the whole thing falls apart.
Yeah, you have a great team over at Crossroads. I enjoy working with them on the singing news side very much so.
Very easy to brag on that bunch over there. And I've been co-producing albums with Jeff Collins over there, who plays piano on a lot of sessions, and he's produced a lot of sessions. He's got such an extraordinary talent as far as background vocals and arrangements too. And so we just, and we've collaborated for so many years that it's just a blast to get with him. And then the creativity just flows. He brings it out of me, and I hope that I bring it out of him. And the same way with Scott, the engineer, and the rest of the guys that play music.
Yeah. So what's next on the horizon for you?
It's just a never ending cycle of when your heart is geared toward what message can I find that will resonate with someone and will speak to their heart. That's what I love about music. Mm-hmm. You know, it's great that, you know, God brings comfort to our hearts. And music brings comfort to our hearts. And when we can bring those together with people that know how to create music, then you've just amplified, mm-hmm. you know, how you can reach people. So we're always looking for new ways to do that. And we're working on a new album now. As a matter of fact, yesterday I was down in Nashville recording. I got my good buddy, Sonia Isaacs. We go, I don't want to say way back because that would be offensive to her. I almost called her an old friend, but we've been friends a long time. Sonia and Becky and Ben and Lily used to make chili for our group. Whenever they came from out of Ohio, and whenever we were singing up there, the Bishops a long time ago, if they weren't singing, instead of getting a hotel, they just gave us the key to their house, and so we'd stay at their house, and Lily would always fix chili for us. And we'd leave a $20 bill, and the next time they came down, they would stay at our house because we were out singing someplace, and then they'd leave that same $20 bill. So we exchanged that $20 bill with the Bishops and the Isaacs, and go back and forth for many years as we'd stay at each other's houses. But anyway, Sonia came down and she sang on this new album, and I've got some other, Allie Griggs is singing with me some on this new album, and it's a project I've been wanting to do for a really long time. The working title is Some Distant Mountain, mm-hmm. and we take that music that came across generations ago from across the ocean, and when it got here and it lived here for a couple of generations, and it began to migrate west through the Appalachian Mountains, and it met that music, what did that music sound like when the Celtic and the Gaelic melodies and lyrics met the Appalachian Mountains and the sounds of the clawhammer banjo and the guitar and the fiddle? So that's where we're shooting for. That's our sweet spot. And we've got an album that I think folks are just going to absolutely fall in love with the sound of it.
Oh, I can't wait to hear that. That sounds
good. It's going to be so cool.
Yeah. Well, Mark, thank you so much for taking time today to talk to Singing News, and congratulations and best of luck on your nomination for the Best Roots Gospel Album.
Well, thank you. Thank you. And thanks to everybody that supported this music through the years.
Absolutely. Thank you.